There's a place I have found in the shade on the ground.
Welcome to the Windows Club. If you encounter quick assist error with the error code 1002 or the error an error has occurred which looks something like this while trying to access the quick assist application, then please watch this video. I will guide you through the resolutions. The first solution is to simply run the quick assist app with administrator privileges. So search for the word quick assist in the Windows search bar. And when the application appears, click on Run as Administrator in the right pane. The next solution is to re-register the Quick Assist app. This can be done using the Windows terminal. Go to the solution number 2 of the original article and copy the command line mentioned here. Now, search for the word WT in the Windows search bar. Click on Run as Administrator in the right pane to open the elevated Windows terminal window. Paste this command here and hit enter. The next solution is to make a few changes to the internet option settings. Press the Windows key and the R button to open the run window. In the run window, type the command inetcpl.cpl and hit enter. This will open the internet properties window. Go to the advanced tab. Scroll down to the security section. You'll notice do not save encrypted pages to disk. Uncheck the checkbox associated with it, click on apply and finally on OK. Next solution will be to run the SFC scan. Search for command prompt in the Windows search bar and click on run as administrator to open the elevated command prompt window. In the elevated command prompt window, type the command SFC /scan now and hit enter to invoke the SFC scan. The scan will check for missing and corrupt files on your computer and replace them if possible. The next solution will be to repair, reset, reinstall the Quick Assist application. Right click on the start button and select settings from the menu. Go to the apps tab on the list on the left hand side. In the right pane, select installed apps. Now wait for the list to load, it may need a minute or maybe a little more than that. Then scroll down to the Quick Assist application. Since the list is in alphabetical order, it will be easy to find. Click on the three dots associated with it and select advanced options. Now scroll down to the reset section. First of all, try repairing the application. If it doesn't work, then reset the application. Click on reset once again. If both of these do not help, then simply uninstall the application and reinstall it from the Microsoft Store. Finally, when everything else fails, you can try an alternative which will be a workaround to this. This has been explained over a separate article. You can try workarounds like AnyDesk, like TeamViewer, like this AmiAdmin and AeroAdmin and so on. Isn't this easy and interesting? If you have any doubts, please go to the original article on the Windows Club, scroll down to the comment section and write your query. We will surely answer to it. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching this video and have a nice day.